Creating a successful website is not a one and done thing. You constantly need to be monitoring how people are using your site and optimizing your site based on user behavior. One of these tools that give you insight into website user behavior is Google Analytics. Google has recently made Google Analytics 4 the default version. And so in this video, I want to cover 7 things you need to know about the new version of Google Analytics. Hi, I'm Phil Sparks with Guiding Digital. My roots are in web development, but I'm passionate about all things web and passing on that knowledge to others. On this channel, I'll be bringing you videos about website best practices. So if you're a new developer, a marketer, or a small business owner trying to soak up all you can about the web, or an experienced person trying to refine your skills, this channel is for you. So subscribe below to stay informed about future content. Website analytics is a crucial part of optimizing your website. Analytics can help you optimize your content and product offerings, help identify UX issues on your site, or help you get to know your customers better. Google Analytics is one of the more popular web analytics offerings. Google has recently released a new version of Google Analytics, Google Analytics 4. In this video, I want to give you 7 things you need to know about the new version. So let's get started. The first thing you need to know about Google Analytics 4 is that it is now the default version. When you create a new analytics property from the Google Analytics admin console, it will now default to Google Analytics 4. Google Analytics 4 was previously known as App plus Web during its beta period, but now Google has renamed it to Google Analytics 4. However, even though with Google Analytics 4 is the default, if needed, you can still create a property using the previous version, which was referred to as Universal Analytics. To create a Universal Analytics property, during the property setup step, click on the Show Advanced Options button, and then click on the Create a Universal Analytics Property toggle. This leads us to the second thing you need to know about Google Analytics 4. As you see here, the setup wizard gives you an option of creating only a universal or both a Google Analytics 4 and a universal analytics property. And so number 2 is that Google Analytics 4 can be installed side by side with Google's universal analytics property. For those creating an analytics property for the first time, you can create a property for both versions during the account create wizard as you see here. For those that have an existing instance of universal analytics but want to create a new Google Analytics 4 property side by side with the previous version, you'll find a GA4 setup assistant link in the property admin section that will guide you through the process. So why would you want to run both side by side instead of just switching to the new version? There are several reasons why you might want to consider this route. First of all, there's no upgrade path from Universal Analytics, so you can't transfer your historical data to your new Google Analytics 4 property. And so for this reason, I would recommend tracking analytics in both Universal Analytics and Google Analytics 4 for a period of time so you can perform period over period analysis. The second reason you might want to use both versions side by side is that Google has stated that all the features available in Universal Analytics are not yet available in Google Analytics 4. For most of us, we won't miss the missing features. But for those that do, by running both, you can continue to use the missing feature in Universal Analytics and still be building up your historical data in your new Google Analytics 4 property in preparation for the time when Google adds your needed feature. The last reason that you might want to run both versions side by side is that some third-party services do not integrate with the new Google Analytics 4 properties just yet. And so by running both side by side, you can continue to use your integration in Universal, but still be building up your historical data in Google Analytics 4. So when should you stop running both side by side? Assuming that all of the features are present that you care about and all the integrations that you use support Google Analytics 4, it's then really about how much historical data do you want so you can easily do period over period comparisons. Tracking data in both versions in most cases doesn't affect your site's performance. And so what I plan to do is to track in both for at least 1 year so I can do year over year comparisons. Number 3, Google Analytics 4 now provides a unified view of activity from your website and your app. In the previous version, Universal Analytics properties could just be used in websites, and there was a separate Google Analytics for Firebase property type for apps. With version 4, both web and app traffic can be collected with the same Google Analytics 4 property. For each website or app install, you set up a data stream within the same property. This ability to collect from apps and websites provide amazing opportunities to see how your users interact with your content from start to finish. Number 4, Google Analytics 4 provides a simplified reporting. In Universal Analytics properties, Google provided dozens of reports for the various reporting categories. In Google Analytics 4, Google has scaled back the number of reports to only a few reports per category. Their goal is to answer the key questions that you may have on the overview page, and then give you the ability to drill into your details if needed. Depending on your perspective, the simplified reporting can be a good or bad thing. If you were an advanced user of reports and Universal Analytics properties, you may find it frustrating that your favorite report or custom report is gone. However, the simplified reporting can be a positive by being less intimidating to new users and exposing the most important metrics upfront. Number 5, Google Analytics 4 provides a new analysis tool. If you're not a fan of Google taking away some of the reports found in Universal Analytics, then maybe the new analysis tool will make up for the missing reports. One of the standout new features, in my opinion, is the powerful new analysis tool. The new analysis tool gives you a lot of flexibility to analyze your data. There are two primary ways to interact with the tool. The first way is by creating a new blank analysis from scratch. Using this method, you can choose your segment, comparison, rows, columns, and the values you want to analyze by dragging the appropriate segment, dimension, or metric into the tab settings section. The report will then dynamically update based on your selection. It's basically a report builder interface. The second way to use this analysis is to start with a predefined template. They currently have 11 predefined templates to choose from. Once you choose a template, you can then modify it by using the same tools as if you were starting from scratch. Number 6, Google Analytics 4 tracks more events by default without extra coding. In the previous version of Google Analytics, if you wanted to track things like outbound link clicks, file downloads, mouse scrolls, you either had to manually set up those events in your Tag Manager solution or add custom code to your website. In Google Analytics 4, by default, Google will track scrolls, outbound clicks, site search interactions, video engagements, and file downloads automatically as long as you leave the enhanced measurements enabled when you initially create your account. Number 7, there's a new data model in Google Analytics 4. In Universal Analytics, there were several different data types such as page views, events, and social events, and several others. In Google Analytics 4, Google has moved to a new data model that now records everything as events. Page views still exist in Google Analytics 4, but they're now page view events. In Universal Analytics, events were custom events that you could set up to track custom actions on your site. In Google Analytics 4, everything is now recorded as events, and you can still set up custom events if needed. One thing to note about custom events, in Universal Analytics, each event had a category, action, and label. In Google Analytics 4, these are no longer standard parameters. You can still add them if you'd like by adding custom event parameters, but they no longer have special meaning in the reports. The last thing I'll note about the new data model is that be aware that your session-related data may be slightly different between Universal Analytics and Google Analytics 4. And so be cautious about comparing metrics like number of sessions or time on site between the two different versions. I'll include a link in the video description that goes into more details on the differences that result because of the new data model. I would encourage you to review that if you have additional concerns on how the new data model might affect your reporting or implementation. Now that you know more about the new version, what's next? Let me suggest two quick things. Number one, even if you're not ready to make the switch yet, set up a Google Analytics 4 property now so you can begin building up historical data. The second thing I would recommend is to take advantage of Google's tutorials on Google Analytics 4. I'll include a link to the tutorial in the video description. Thanks for watching today. If you found this video useful, give me a like. Make sure and subscribe if you want more content on web best practices. Also, if you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave me a question below and I'll try to respond to each one. Thanks.